Hi, I'm Carl from Apt, and in this video I'll be giving you a closer look at a great option in the mid-level AV receiver category, the Denon AVRS660H. If you're watching this on YouTube, be sure to click the link in the description after the video to see our most current pricing, and don't forget to like and subscribe so you can stay up to date on all of our latest products. This receiver has a traditional design with the volume and source select knobs to the right and left of the display, and a power button down in the bottom left-hand corner, and additional shortcut buttons below the display. It comes in a black finish, sits at 8.4 inches high, 17.1 inches wide, 13.34 inches deep, and weighs just under 17.25 pounds. Around back, you'll find an assortment of connections, both digital and analog. Starting off, there are 6 total assignable HDMIs, which can all handle 4K at 120 Hz, along with variable refresh rates and auto low latency mode, which are great features for next gen gamers, but numbers 4, 5, and 6 can additionally pass through an 8K 60 Hz signal too. They also support the latest relevant video formats like HDR 10+, Dolby Vision, and HLG. Just to the right of those is a single HDMI output with an enhanced audio return channel. Next is an Ethernet port for a hardwired network connection, although it also has Wi-Fi built in if you can't hardwire it, and Bluetooth for doing things like streaming music saved on your phone or connecting a pair of wireless headphones. Then you have 2 optical and a single digital coaxial input, 2 analog video inputs, a single analog video out, 2 subwoofer pre-outs, 2 analog audio inputs, phonograph input with a ground connection, and AM and FM antenna inputs. At the bottom are connections for up to 5 speakers. And finally, if you move back to the front of the receiver, you'll see a single USB input for connecting a storage device like a thumb drive or an external hard drive. Now, touching back on those speaker inputs, this can support up to 5.2 channels, meaning you can play back formats like DTS HD Master, Dolby True HD, and ProLogic 2. It also supports high-res files like ALAC, FLAC, and WAV at up to 192.24. Unfortunately, though, it doesn't support height channels, so you can't get things like Dolby Atmos or DTS:X, but that's partly why this falls into such an affordable price category, and what it has definitely outweighs what it's missing. To navigate through the menus and options, you can either use the Denon Remote app on a smart device or the remote Denon includes in the box. On that remote, you'll find buttons for each input up at the top, and at the very bottom are controls for 4 different preset sound modes: movie, music, game, and pure. The AVRS660H is not short on smart features either. It's compatible with Amazon and Google Assistants, Siri, Josh AI, and AirPlay 2, so it'll integrate easily into almost any smart home, and it also features Denon HEOS for multi-room streaming. Now, if you're not familiar with HEOS, it basically consolidates all your music apps into a central location, the HEOS app, and lets you control them all from your phone, computer, or tablet. If you have additional HEOS speakers, you can tell each one which song to play or tell them all to play the same song. It's really easy to use and kind of gives you the option to have music throughout your home without needing to run wires everywhere. But it's not just the smart features and inputs that make this an excellent mid-price option. Denon also includes their Odyssey Room Correction System, which is a must to use once you have this connected to all your speakers. It utilizes a microphone that reads test tones that get broadcast through your speakers to optimize the sound to the room. And just like the HEOS app, it's super easy to use, so even a novice can take advantage without any trouble. So, who's this receiver for? This is a really good option for someone maybe already using a 5-channel surround setup but has an older receiver that needs replacing, or someone looking for a great value who doesn't need all the bells and whistles. It works with a wide variety of smart systems, has 8K pass-through, and all the major next-gen gaming features, but it's only set up for a single zone. It can't play back 3D audio like Atmos or DTS:X, so you're not gonna get those overhead effects. And although it handles small to medium-sized speakers extremely well, you'll probably want something a little more powerful if you have larger tower speakers you're trying to drive. I'll put a link to a model with more power down in the description. If you still have questions on the AVRS660H or you need any assistance choosing a new receiver, be sure to contact our experts here at Apt. We're always happy to help. Thanks as always for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.